Yes.
And your speech then about, and you mentioned like thou shalt not steal, and
yeah,
we're actually walking around and doing a bit of pieces about stealing today.
Right.
And we was wondering if we could possibly get you film you saying.
You can film me. You can film me. Yeah.
In that bit that you just said just before, just about felt like.
I'll be preaching that in a minute. So
yeah,
you could.
Cool, okay,
you
cool, they're just there. So is it okay if we come back and get that?
Yeah. Yeah. I'll be preaching. I'll be preaching. So you can film me. I'll be preaching.
Yeah, so anyway, but your problem is your side mark, what's your name, mate?
Jason.
Nice to meet you, Jason, nice to meet you. You know what? From these days, I know, right, stealing stars and lying stars and all that. You know what? Streets ain't safe, you've got gangs of youth going around, doing terrible things to people. It's just depraved, isn't it?
It is, but the thing is, Christ died on the cross and shed his blood for our sin, yeah?
Gave his
life for us. That's why we're here today.
I know.
Yeah, I'm going to preach now, yes.
Hey, is that all right?
Yeah.
All right. I'll leave you to it. All right.
We're dealing with the police about stealing and stuff like that. So, and I suddenly heard you say, thou shalt not steal. And I thought, well, that's perfect, isn't it?
Okay, I'll be preaching that, yeah.
Yes. Okay, so if you ignore us, off you go.
So we're here today to share the gospel today. And that gospel is Jesus Christ the Saviour. But it says this, thou shalt not steal. Have you stolen this week? Have you stolen from your workplace? Have you stolen from college? Have you stolen? Thou shalt not steal. Stealing is wrong. Why? Because God tells you. Why? Because your conscience tells you. It's wrong. But guess what? That Christ died for your stealing on that cross. Jesus died for your stealing today. And if you turn to him, you can be saved and born again. Thou shalt not lie, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not commit adultery. Don't do these things. Turn away and remember that Christ died for you on that cross. He gave his life for you on that cross. God bless, have a nice day. He gave his life for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He gave his life that you may live, that you may have a future today. That's why he died on that cross, to give you a hope, to give you a purpose, to give you a plan today. Thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt honor your father and mother. Thou shalt keep the Sabbath day. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. And thou shalt not curse the name of the Lord. No swearing. No cursing. You don't need to swear. You don't need to swear. You need Christ, who died on that cross and gave his life for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. And if you trust him today, you can know him as your Lord and Savior. He says, the goodness and kindness of the Lord. Will you do that today? Will you know that Christ died for you on that cross? Christ gave his life for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He gave his life for you on that cross, that you may be reconciled to God. Oh, my friends, to know God is a wonderful thing. To be right with God is a beautiful thing. To know God is a wonderful thing. And Christ paid your debt. Christ paid your debt on that cross. He gave, God bless you, he gave his life for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He gave his life for you on that cross. My friends, will you trust him today? Will you believe in him today? Will you look to him today? Will you turn to him today? Taste and see that the Lord is good. He is a good Savior. He is a beautiful Savior who wants to forgive you, wants to restore you, wants to clean you. Will you trust him today? Will you trust him today and know the peace of God in your life? Trust him today and know the love of God in your life. Will you do that today? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have eternal life. You begin to trust in him and believe in him, the Savior, who will cleanse you and wash you and make you anew. He'll restore you and forgive you and cleanse you and make you anew. That's what he'll do for you. He'll save you if you trust him. He'll save you if you believe in him. He'll save you if you look to him. He'll save you as you look to him and trust in him as your Savior. He will save you, but you got to go to him. Don't go to drugs. Don't go to drugs. Don't go to getting drunk. Don't go to sex and ruin your life with sex outside of marriage. Don't do that to your body. Don't do it to your mind. But go to Christ who'll save you. Christ who died for you. Christ who gave his life for you. Who shed his blood for you on that cross. Go to him who can forgive you. Who can cleanse you. Who can restore you. Go to him. Go to him. Go to him, my friends. Oh, the deep, deep blood of Jesus, vast, unmeasured, boundless, free, rolling as a mighty ocean in its fullness over me, the mighty love of God. Oh, go to him today. Go to Christ and meet the Savior of your soul. Meet the Shepherd of your life. Meet the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Go to him and meet him in your life. Meet him and trust him and come to know him as your Lord and Savior and find peace in your life. Find the Savior who will forgive you, the Savior who will cleanse you, the Savior who will restore you. Oh Christ, how beautiful he is, how wonderful he is that he'll forgive you. How merciful he is that he will cleanse you. How tender he is that he will forgive you. Oh, Christ will forgive you. Christ will forgive you. He'll forgive you. He'll be merciful. He'll be kind. He'll show you his mercy if you cry out to him and go to him today. He says, knock and you will find. Knock and you will find. Knock on heaven's door. Say, Christ, forgive me. Christ, have mercy upon me. And you will find love and mercy in your life. You'll find the Son of God who gave his life for you. You will find him in the night. You will find him in the morning. You will find him, Christ the Savior. Christ the light of the world. Christ is here for you today. Christ the Savior. Christ the Lord. Christ the King. Christ the bread of Lamb. Christ the light of the world. Christ is alive. He died and rose again. Christ. Oh, come and look at Christ the Savior. Look at Christ the Lord. Look at him who died. Look at him who rose. Look at him who shed his blood. Christ. Will you not trust Christ tonight? You trust him as your Lord and Savior. Will you not do that tonight? Will you not do that tonight? Trust him as your Lord and Savior. Trust him as your King. And know his love in your life. Know his peace in your life. The joy of God in your life. The mercy of God in your life. He is alive. He died and rose again. And he is alive. The light of the world is alive today. The light of the world is alive. And you can know him today. And he says to you today, come to me. All you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He will give you rest in the midst of the storm. He'll give you rest as you trust him. He'll give you rest where you cannot find peace. He'll give you rest as you trust him. Come to me, he says. All you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He will give you rest, my friend. God bless you. He will give you rest. He'll give you rest as you trust him. So come to him and lean upon him. Lean upon his love. Lean upon Christ. Lean upon the Savior. Lean upon the Lord and find peace for your soul. Mercy for your soul. Kindness for your soul. Lean upon him and trust him as your Lord and Savior. Trust him as your Lord and Savior. Go to him. Say, Lord, I've got a problem with drugs. I've got a problem with sex. I've got a problem with drink. I've got a problem in my life. And go to him and cry out to him. And he'll show you his mercy. He'll show you his love. He'll show you his kindness. Go to him. Find his peace, find his love in your life. Find Christ in your life. No Christ in your life. Christ. No Christ. No Christ in your life. No, the love of God, the love of Christ, the love of Jesus, the love of the Lord, sir. No, no, Christ. Christ is better than drugs. Christ is better than alcohol. Christ. You need Christ in your life. Christ can save you. Christ can do you good. If you take spice, it'll take it out of you. Take drugs, it'll take it out of you. If you take selfishness, it'll take it out of you. But Christ, he wants to fill you with his joy. He says, I've come to give you life, abundant life. There's abundant life in Christ. Abundant life in Jesus, abundant life in the Savior, abundant life in the Lord today. Oh, there's abundant life in Christ. Will you not trust him today? Why would you not trust him? Why would you continue to go on and then fall into hell? Why would you do that and plunge into hell and weep and gnash forever and ever? No, don't do that. Don't do that to yourself. Christ knocks on your heart tonight and he says, come to him. Come to him as your Lord. Come to him as your Savior. Come to him who died on a cross. Come to him who gave his life for you. Come to him who shed his blood for you. Come to him. He's waiting that you come to him. He's waiting that you trust him. He's waiting for you. Come. Come, come to Christ. He died and paid your debt. He paid his debt, your debt, with his life. He shed his blood with his life. He gave his life for you. He shed his blood for you. Come, don't go to the drugs. Don't go to the drink. Come to Christ. Have faith, believe in him, trust him. Go to him, the Lord of glory, the Lord who died for you, the Lord who shed his blood for you, the Lord who gave himself for you on a cross. He died for you on a cross. He gave himself for you on a cross. Come to him. Come to Christ today. Don't go along your life without Christ. Don't go along without him. Make sure you trust him as your Savior. Make sure you believe in him. Make sure you make him your Lord and Savior in your life. Make sure you trust Jesus as your Savior, Jesus as your Lord. Make sure you believe in him and trust him as your Lord and Savior. Make sure you do that, my friends, and find the peace of God in your life and the joy of the Lord in your life and the mercy of God in your life. And the tenderness of God. Will you not do that today? Christ, Christ the Lord today. He's the Lord and he's alive today. He's alive to set you free today. He can set you free today. He can set you free and give you a new life today. God bless you. If you trust him, he can set you free. If you trust him, he can give you a new life today if you trust him. Trust him today and call upon him. And have faith in him who gave his life for you. Have faith in him who died for you. Have faith in him who loved you. Have faith in him who shed his blood for you. Have faith in him who gave his life for you. Have faith in him, Christ. Have faith in him. Come to me. All you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He will give you rest tonight. He'll give you rest from the storm, from your drug addiction, from your alcohol addiction, from your sex addiction. Whatever your addiction is tonight, he'll set you free. Christ will set you free from your addictions tonight. He'll set you free tonight because he's the Lord, my friends. He's the Lord of glory. He's the King of kings and Lord of glory. And he can set you free tonight. He can make you anew tonight. He can change you tonight. He can change you, sir, and make you anew. So come to him tonight and trust him as your Lord and Savior. Trust him who came and died for you. Trust him who shed his blood for you. Trust him as your Savior. Trust him as your Lord. Trust him today. Trust him as your King today. Trust him as your Lord today. Trust him, my friends. He'll never let you down. He'll never ever forsake you. He'll always be there for you. It's an old hymn, just as I am, without one plea, that thy blood was shed for me. Oh, the blood of Christ was shed. God bless you, have a nice day. The blood of Jesus Christ was shed on that cross, and he paid the debt for your sin. He paid your debt. Don't be proud. Don't be proud and arrogant and scoff at God. Don't do it to yourself. Don't do it to yourself. Don't do that to yourself. Don't be proud and don't scoff. But remember that Christ is a Savior for you if you would believe him. He's a Savior for you if you will trust him. He's a Savior for you if you will have faith in him. Come. Come to Christ today and trust him as your Lord. Assalamu alaikum. Are you a Muslim?
Yes, sir.
Do you read your Quran? I'll put it that way, yeah? Don't worry. Do you read your Quran?
Yes, sir.
Why would you say you're a Muslim?
What?
Why would you say you're a Muslim? Is there any reasons why you're a Muslim?
Because it's the last religion.
Okay.
Yeah.
But how do you get forgiven in Islam? You know, if you sin, how do you get forgiven in Islam? You know, if you do something wrong, how do you get forgiven?
First, I get away from something that I have done.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, I avoid it. And I ask for God.
And do you know your sins are forgiven today?
What?
Do you know that your sins are forgiven today?
What?
You know, you say how you get forgiven.
Yeah.
Do you know today that you're forgiven? Today. Do you know if you were to die right now, do you know that you're forgiven?
No, I don't.
Well, in the Bible, in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, it says this. It says, if you confess, I'll read it to you. I'll read it to you.
So that's what...
Well, it's a famous passage. I'll read it. It's in the Bible. And it says this. It says, verse 9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So what it's saying there is a promise from God that if you confess your sin, you can be forgiven. You know why? Because when Christ came, Jesus Christ was your Savior.
Yeah.
Right? And the reason why he was the Savior, because you know in the Old Testament there were sacrifices for sin. Do you remember in the Quran it talks about Abraham?
Yeah.
To sacrifice his son, and then he didn't. Mm. Yeah, do you remember that?
And God
that's it.
Changed his son with a sheep.
That's it, yeah. Yeah, well that teaches us that God has given us a final sheep, a final shepherd.
There
and
you go.
So when John the Baptist saw Jesus, he said this, remember Abraham and the sheep. Yeah? When John the Baptist saw Jesus, he said this, behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world.
I see.
So when Christ came, in the Quran it says that Jesus was at the Word of God and the Spirit of God. In the Quran it says that Jesus had a virgin birth. Why? Because he had to be perfect. Was he perfect? He was the Lamb that was shed for you. So he was sacrificed on your behalf. When he died, all the things that you've done wrong, have you ever lied?
Okay, Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jesus didn't die.
Okay, who died then on the cross? What's his name?
It's not Jesus.
But who is it though?
It's someone looked like Jesus.
What's his name?
I don't know actually.
Well, I know who he was.
You know, I hate that kind of conversation because I don't have that kind of information, so I can't discussion with you.
Don't worry. Nobody knows. But so, from the Islamic point of view, but we know from the Christian point of view, it was Jesus. You know why? because at the cross, Mary, his mother, was there. So surely Mary would have... Yeah. So surely anybody, who's anybody, would know whether her son was dying on a cross or not. And God would not deceive their own mother. And so the mother was there, and Mary saw Jesus dying on a cross.
Yeah, as I told you.
So we know that it's Mary.
Yeah. As I told you.
Sorry, it's Jesus. Yeah, it's Jesus that died on the cross.
Jesus didn't die. He is the God. How can I say it in English? The God bring him to him. So he's alive. He will come back in the end of the world with the Ajuj, Majuj. Do you know that name? These two will come to the end of the world. So they will kill everybody. So Jesus will come and kill those two. Yeah. And the Quran say, if you see these two person, stay away from them. Try to run. If they, for example, if they in Italia run to Spain, if they run away from them. Mm. So that's it.
Okay.
Well, because in Quran said that Jesus, it's not die, it's look like that okay. Jesus, but it's not Jesus.
I've listened to you with respect.
Yeah, thank you.
You know, but we have lots of evidence to show, right? The Quran came 600 years after Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have eyewitnesses that came that are in documents that came 50 to maybe 100 years after Jesus, but based on eyewitnesses. So Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, two of them are eyewitnesses, Matthew and John.
I don't know Matthew.
Well, they're Injil. So they're eyewitnesses.
Oh, Injil, yeah.
Yeah. And then Mark wrote from Peter's point of view, and Luke gathered eyewitnesses. So they're all based on eyewitnesses. So who are you going to believe, the eyewitnesses or the Quran that came 600 years later? So I'm keeping it over there somewhere. So who are you going to believe? Eyewitnesses. Of people who Jesus appointed as leaders in his church. Apostles, great leaders, Matthew and John, and other people like Luke and Mark, who are based on eyewitnesses. So there's lots of evidence. But not with the eyewitnesses, there's more evidence.
Look,
in 98...
My English is weak.
Yes,
okay,
yes.
Okay, so try to speak with...
A bit slower, yeah.
The famous one.
Emphasis, yeah. Okay, well, there's Josephus, a Jewish historian, who came from Galilee, and he lived around about 70-80 AD, and he wrote that Jesus died under Pontius Pilate. And then a Roman historian, Tacitus, who lived 90 to 100 AD, wrote that Jesus died under Pontius Pilate. So we have eyewitnesses, and then we have enemies against Jesus, all saying that he died.
But I heard that...
I'm just looking at this just in case it finishes, yeah.
Okay. But in Quran says that Jesus is not dead yet.
Yeah.
He is not dead yet. Yeah. He will come back in the end of the world.
I'll just get you back there so they know I'm talking. So. Yeah, go on.
Yeah, it's okay.
Hey, mate, you all right?
How you doing?
You all right, bro? God bless you.
Good
to see you. Yeah, God bless you. Take care, mate. Yeah, can I put it on you just a bit?
No.
Right, go on. You didn't get your face, don't worry.
Yeah. The Quran says that Jesus is not dead, he will come back at the end of the world.
Yeah.
So, with a little people who were caving in some place.
Right.
Yeah, so. Look, I'm sorry, my English is weak.
No, you're doing fine. You're doing great.
Okay, so
you're doing really good, mate.
Okay, thank you. I believe Quran because the God says I will save it, that Quran, until the end of the world. So it's not, you know, anybody can not change anything.
Yes. Yes.
So it's the word of the God and of the Prophet Muhammad. Please.
Okay. I respect that, and I can see you have a sincere heart.
Yeah.
You're a very honest, sincere man, and I can see that. And I'm here today to do what you would do for Islam, Dawah for Christianity.
No, actually, I don't do
that one. But I do preaching for Jesus, yeah. And I'm here to tell you.
Listen, point.
Well, you talked a lot then, and I listened to you.
Okay.
Can I finish my point, please?
A little point that the NGL is not right.
Okay, you've said a lot. Let me finish now.
Okay.
Let me finish. I've listened to you a lot, right? I've given you some evidence about the death of Jesus. I've given you historical evidence, yeah? And what you're saying, your reply is, well, the Quran is the word of God because God says it is. He's going to preserve it, right? But that's a circular argument. It's like saying, I'm right because I'm right. It's circular. You've got to have some kind of evidence. I've given you some evidence, some historical evidence outside the Quran, outside the Bible, that verifies the Bible.
I don't have evidence.
Well,
I told you, I'm not that brain that knows
what I'm saying is
history or kind
of
that.
But I'm telling you not to have a blind faith. I'm saying believe in Jesus, that he died and rose again for you, because there's evidence that he died and that he rose again. And I've given you evidence about his death. My friend, if you died tonight,
okay,
where would you go if you died tonight?
Tonight? I will go to the what?
Hell?
No.
Purgatory?
No, in the land.
The grave? The floor?
Yeah, under the floor.
Under the floor, okay.
Yeah.
Well, you can go two places.
Oh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When the thief was on the cross, when they were on the cross, Jesus said to one of them who believed, today you will be with me in paradise. Right? My friend, when you die, you need to be know where you stand. And Jesus died and rose again, he conquered death. And if you believe in him, I promise you, if you believe in him,
I believe him.
Yeah, but not as the Son of God, not as someone who died for your sin, not as someone who rose again. The Quran contradicts that. It says that he is not the Son of God. It says that he did not die, so therefore he did not rise again. Whereas we believe he was the Son of God, he died and rose again. And we believe that is the only way that you can get saved. And John the Baptist says, behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. And that's what we're preaching today, bro. And honestly, my friend, all I can say is that if you do good deeds, or if you try to do it yourself, you become guilty. But if you go to Jesus and say, forgive me, you'll find a peace and a forgiveness because he's died for you. And it says this in Romans 5, therefore we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. In other words, there's no wrath anymore. There's this peace with God. And that's what we want for you. I don't want you to go to hell. I don't want you to be in hell. I want you to know the love of God in your life. And I would ask you to do this. At least go and read your Quran, and then get a Bible and read the Injil. And be open and say, God, is it Quran or is it Bible? And read it and be open and see. Check it out. It even commands you to stand on the Injil and the Torah. Okay?
Here we go.
I'll give you some stuff for you. Have you got some stuff? There's got. There we are.
What's
okay,
this?
That's just a leaflet, and I give you. There, you are. That's my website on there, and you can study Islam on there. But it's respectful, yeah.
Okay, I see.
Okay, all right. God bless you.
Well, thanks a lot.
Lovely to talk to you. Yeah. What's your name?
Abdullah.
Abdullah, nice to meet you, Abdullah.
You
Jason.
Too. Yeah, right
hand. Oh, right hand. God bless you. Abdullah, good to meet you.
Okay.
Take care, bro.
Thank you,
God bless
friend.
You, man.
All right. I'll get off now.